Madam, I thank members for their views and suggestions. NQC Deputy Sec Jen Heng Chi Hao and several members have shared that on the ground, there's growing concern on job opportunities and job security. I can understand. Retrenchment has gone up highest since the global financial crisis in 2009. Unemployment, though low, has gone up too. Resident unemployment rate now held steady at about 2.8% for 4 years since 2012, but went up to 3% last year. As we transform to take our Singapore economy into the future, some may wonder, what will the future economy bring us? Will more workers be displaced by technology? Will more workers be made redundant? Will more jobs go to foreigners? Will the rise of digital and gig economy change the employment landscape, resulting in less employment and more freelancing? In short, will we have enough jobs, enough good jobs? Or will more workers be hit by unemployment, underemployment, and structural unemployment? Madam, this cannot be the kind of future we want for our workers, our people, our children. The purpose of us transforming towards our future economy is to improve our jobs, our careers, our life, not to make them worse. Of course, there's no guarantee that all economic transformations will be successful, as seen in failures in some countries. But for Singapore, we've succeeded time and time again so far. So working together, whole of Singapore, we must make sure that we succeed again. This will not be easy, because to open the door to a future of good jobs and better careers for all our people, we must have not one, not two, but actually four keys in our hand. The first key is a key of quality job creation. To create enough jobs of good enough qualities for everyone, young and old, PMETs and rank and file. Madam, the net growth in our total employment, excluding foreign domestic worker, has slowed significantly. From more than 200,000 a year before the global financial crisis, to more than 100,000 a year after the global financial crisis, to less than 25,000 in 2015, and less than 10,000 last year. Why? There are two reasons for this. Externally, due to business uncertainty, companies are hiring less. The recruitment rate for companies with 25 or more employees has come down from 2.8 new employees per 100 existing employees in 2012 to about 2.2 last year. But more importantly, internally, our local workforce growth has slowed quite significantly. With aging and low birth rate, coupled with already high labor force participation rate, local workforce growth is heading for stagnation over the next 10 years. Slowdown in hiring is cyclical. It will pick up again when business sentiment improves. But slowdown in our local workforce growth is structural. Our local workforce growth will never go back to the high growth of 2%, 3%, 4% of the past. Hence, if we try to bring employment growth back to 100,000 a year, we'll need to bring in many more foreign workers. And if we take in 50,000 more a year, this will mean 500,000 over 10 years. Higher economic gains will come with even higher social costs. This is not what we want. We have little choice but to learn to how to grow our economy with a workforce growth of about 1% from now on. And this means about 33,000 net increase in total employment a year. There will be fluctuations from year to year, so some years more, maybe 25,000, or rather some year less, maybe 25,000, some years maybe more, maybe 40,000. So 25,000 to 40,000, this range should be achievable. But even so, we will still be faced with the challenge of rising underemployment. This will happen when the improvement in job quality, not just new jobs, but also our existing jobs, is not able to keep pace with improvement in education and skill profile of our local workforce. So far, the overall quality of our local employment has been improving. The proportion of PMET jobs has increased from 49% in 2007 to 55% last year. As we help every worker to upgrade to become a better worker, we need to make every job a better job, every career a better career. Will we succeed? I believe we can, but only if we look at technology, not as our competitor for jobs, but as our partner in the creation of jobs, quality jobs. Madam, technology is a main driving force of future growth globally. We can either use it to our advantage or allow competitors to use it to our disadvantage. The choice is clear. To be on the winning side, we need to keep crossing the technology gate better and faster than the competition, so that we will not end up in the black hole of global competition. However, with so many innovations out there, crossing the first scale of technology is essential, but will not be enough. There's still the second gate to cross, the market gate, to compete successfully for customers and build market share. Those who fail, again, will end up in the black hole of global competition. To cross the two gates, we have been building our bridge of innovation. Our next challenge is to make this bridge of innovation longer, stronger, and wider, so that many more can get through as individual companies, as clusters of industry, and as one future economy. And not just the pioneers, not just the early adopters, but the early majority, and eventually the late majority as well. Some may wonder, the more we strengthen the bridge of innovation, wouldn't technology take away even more jobs from us? Kraftmark is a distributor and retailer of over 20 brands of footwear and leather goods and accessories. With the use of RFID, it cuts down man hour for stock taking by 90%. Workers were redeployed to serve customers better. As a result, they achieve not just better business for the owners, but also better jobs for the workers. So the keywords for the MOM is better jobs. The Soup Spoon is a popular restaurant chain with more than 20 outlets. To expand overseas, the company decided to move from food retail to include food manufacturing as well. So with automated packaging process, its operation is not only competitive, but also 25% more manpower lean. So the keywords for the MOM are manpower lean. Tiong Seng is a market leader in construction. To maximize the impact of using a technology known as the Building Information Modeling, BIM. The company helps all its subcontractors to adopt the same technology. And as a result, they improve productivity, not just within the company, but across the entire value chain by 35%. So the keywords for MOM are productivity gain. Madam, these companies show us that the real threat we face in the competition for jobs it's not technology, but global competition. So instead of worrying about technology taking away our jobs, we should focus more on how to partner with technology to take away customers, to take away jobs from our competitors before they do this to us. This is why, over a year ago, MOM initiated the Lean Enterprise Development Scheme, LEDS, to bring various agencies together to provide a one-stop service, making it easier for the SMEs to develop business capability, manpower development, and market development. Where necessary, MOM is even prepared to allow short-term flexibility on foreign manpower quota to help make changes happen faster.